Hello YouTube! Today I will once again do a theory on the Elder Scrolls. And I must admit, this theory is kind of far-fetched. I know that a lot of people will disagree, and that's okay. And you can put your disagreements in the comments, but please accept that this is a theory, and I don't think that this is canon lore at all, so please don't bother me with things like "you're an idiot, this is not canon," because I know it's not canon. I delete those comments, so don't bother. You can disagree, but keep it civil. And I must also admit that this is not my theory. It's a theory that I read somewhere online about 10 months ago now. And I cannot find the original theory anymore, so I cannot properly credit the author. I believe it was on GameFAQs. But if anyone knows this theory and can point me to the original author, please tell me, then I can credit him in the description. That said, while the article did not stick with me, the theory did. So let's kick off. So when I read this theory, I was wondering on how on earth Titus Mead I, the grandfather of the current emperor from Skyrim, Titus Mead II, came to power. All we know is that he was a powerful Kolovian warlord during the beginning of the Fourth Era. That really begs the question, why don't we already see him in the Elder Scrolls IV Oblivion, or at least hear of him? Because apparently he's a powerful warlord and he has enough troops to take over the Imperial City, because that's what he did, but that will come there later. I mean, don't get me wrong, I understand Bethesda probably had not written the lore for Skyrim yet, blah 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 blah, but they could at least given us a name we already knew, like one of the counts of the cities in Cyrodiil. If one of those had taken over the Imperial City during the time after the Oblivion Crisis, then it would have made sense, we would have known the family that would have taken over. But we don't know. They just picked the name Titus Mead and said that he was a Kolovian warlord. They chose some unknown warlord. But what if we did know him, or well, not really knew him, but what if we had interactions with him, or at least indirectly? What if there's a link between the character we know in Oblivion and the Mead dynasty? Let's start at the beginning. Titus Mead conquered the Imperial City with about 1,000 men, according to the lore. That was about 17 years after the Oblivion Crisis, and it's quite an accomplishment. I would guess that those men were mercenaries and not Imperial soldiers, but I have no hard evidence for that, so let's just keep it out of the picture. But I think it's still strange that a Kolovian warlord can just take over the Imperial City with 1,000 men, while the Elvish armies, well, had to fight hard for it, and seemingly he just did it with 1,000 men. But again, I don't have any hard evidence on those men or at the defenses of the Imperial City. All we know is that with 1,000 men he did it. But it doesn't matter how much men it were, because it could also be that it were a lot of more men, but that just like they do in like North Korea and say that Kim Jong-un does not poop or anything, it could also be that it's a made-up story, that he had actually a lot of more troops, and that by portraying him as some military genius, he wanted to alter his own image by just saying that it were just 1,000 men. But it still begs the question, where did he get those men from? Because he did not did it alone, we can be very sure of that. Well, you could argue that he just hired them. While that might of course be true, I have a more far-fetched answer. In Oblivion, there's a Dark Brotherhood quest named Bad Medicine. To be quick, this is a quest in which the protagonist is tasked with killing a Kolovian warlord in his fort, but without killing the mercenaries. I find this very particular. Why on earth would anyone want a dead warlord's troop alive? You would at least, just like in Skyrim, you always kill the bandits, not just the bandit chief. Unless this person that hired the Dark Brotherhood wanted to use these warriors. What if Titus Mead was actually this warlord's successor to the throne? I know this is all very far-fetched, but it works with the timeline, since it's just a few years later Mead would capture the Imperial City with just a small band of soldiers. Although much larger than the original band of mercenaries in the fort, but he must have had some time to expand during the years after Oblivion. That said, it is very far-fetched, but there's one more piece of evidence. One thing that at least convinced me to at least partly believe in this theory. One thing that makes this theory a little more plausible. The Skyrim Dark Brotherhood questline. In the final quest to kill the Emperor, Titus Mead II, the grandson of the guy that conquered the Imperial City, you assassinate him, and he says, "I told Commander Morrow, you cannot stop a Dark Brotherhood assassin. No one can." This can of course be because he has heard the tales of the Dark Brotherhood, but it can also be because the Dark Brotherhood put his own family to power because they were hired by his grandfather to take over the Forge troops by assassinating his grandfather's superior and putting his grandfather in charge of those mercenaries. Of course, this theory is very far-fetched, and maybe I'm connecting dots that don't exist, but to me it's the first explanation for the sudden rise of an Oblivion unknown powerful warlord that I have seen. Or I'm just crazy. Anyway, thanks for watching, I really hope that you liked it, and this was kind of a bonus video because I had promised to do the Crestius Curio video first, but that will come still later this week, because I was planning on only making a video later this week. But then I was like, I was thinking about this theory, and I was like, oh, maybe I should do a video about it, because I really think it's an interesting theory. It doesn't have to necessarily be true, but I think it's plausible. And I really hope that anyone can find the original author of it, because I don't really like copying people without crediting them. So please email, call, comment me, just make sure I get to know who wrote the theory so I can credit him at least in the description. That said, leave a like if you enjoyed the video, subscribe, and check out my Steam page for channel updates if you're interested in that kind of thing. Or just add me on Steam if you want to talk to me personally. I mean, I'm mostly in for a chat, so. And I will see you guys later in the next lore video, I think in about 3-4 days. No promises.